Well, he's got Nigerian roots, Canadian citizenship, and now a home team here in Iowa. On tonight's Sunday Sports Extra, hear why Melvin Ejim is so happy to be a Cyclone.
He could be in Nigeria right now.
My parents, they always let us know that things were different when we're there from.
But Melvin Ejim's family moved to Canada right before he was born.
My brothers and sisters should be very grateful for the things that we have and the ability to, you know, achieve great things academically and with me with sports.
Growing up in Toronto, Ejim played on traveling AAU teams. At one tournament south of the Canadian border, Ejim made the first of what turned out to be many life-altering connections.
And at a tournament in D.C., there were some schools there that seen me and they asked me. And then from there, we started communicating and we started talking about going down there and providing scholarships. And that's kind of how it went down.
His hoops journey was about to take off. At age 15, he left home to play for a prep school, St. Mary's Riken in Southern Maryland.
I lived with a great host family that I'm still in touch with.
Prior to his junior year in high school, Ejim moved again, this time to Brewster Academy in New Hampshire, known for producing multiple Division I players each year. All he did there was lead his team to a championship and win state Gatorade Player of the Year honors in 2010.
I didn't come from a wealthy family by any means, and a lot of people, like I said, in my community with my coaches and my team really helped me to get to the United States and from there to get to, good schools that were helpful for me.
When it came time to choose a college, another connection came in handy.
You know, Craig Brackens had also gone to Brewster Academy, so Iowa State was always up there recruiting. So that's how my whole getting from Canada to the United States to Iowa State went down.
Once he became a Cyclone, he had to prove himself all over again.
You got to go out with a little chip.
At 6'6", he's out battling much bigger opponents.
You know, guys, you know, whenever they see somebody small, you know, it's automatic, like, you know, bring the ball here. It's a mismatch. I got this guy. So, but, you know, you always got to go out there and show, like, you know, this is not going to be as easy as you think it is. And I'm not going to back down just because I might be a little bit smaller than you.
This season, his 9 rebounds per game are best in the Big 12 Conference.
What I lack in size, I make up in effort and in hearts.
He leads the Big 12 and leads his team. He was voted captain as a junior.
Over the time that I've been here, you know, I've accumulated a certain amount of respect and they appreciate that.
Almost a 4-point student. The academic awards that he's gotten over the past couple years are awesome. You know, not many people. You know, Melvin's one of those guys that'll do whatever he wants to do when he's done playing basketball.
But for now, it is basketball.
Oh, this was something that I really strived for.
And he couldn't be happier that his journey has landed him at Iowa State.
And now that I'm doing it, and now that I'm doing well and playing and having fun, it is really like a dream come true, you know. So hopefully this dream can keep lasting for a long time and past the collegiate level, and hopefully I can continue to play basketball for really long.